Good morning, children. Welcome back. I am Mrs. Sitara, your social science teacher. Today we will see Civics Unit 1, Equality, Part 3. Children, in the last class, we saw the different types of equality: social equality, civil equality, political equality, and gender equality. Social equality means that all citizens are entitled to enjoy equal status in society and they are not discriminated against caste, creed, color or race, and they are given equal opportunity to develop their personality. We also saw what was civil equality. Civil equality is the enjoyment of civil rights by all the citizens without any discrimination of superior or inferior, rich or poor, caste or creed, and nobody should be denied enjoyment of any rights. We also saw political equality, where in democratic countries like India, its citizens are guaranteed political rights. It includes the right to vote, the right to hold public office, and the right to criticize the government. In India, the voting right is given to all the citizens who has attained 18 years of age without any discrimination. Today, we are going to discuss about gender equality. Now, we will see what is gender equality. Children, all human beings, both men and women, are free to develop their personal abilities and make choices without any limitations. That means, in a society, both man and woman are free to have their own personal choices, are free to develop their personality, and they are not restricted, they are not limited to prove themselves. Both men and women are free to develop their personal abilities. They can have their own choices. They can develop themselves without anyone limiting their ability because they are of their gender. Nowadays, they are given equal opportunities, but it was not so in the earlier days. Women were not given equal rights and they were considered as weak as compared to man, and they were placed in a secondary position to man. In earlier days in our society, women were considered as weak and they were placed in a secondary position. They were not given equal rights along with men. But that is not so. Times have changed and now women should be treated equally. It does not mean that women and men have to become the same, but that their rights, responsibilities and opportunities will not depend whether they are born male or female. It doesn't mean men and women are the same. It doesn't mean they have to become the same. But their rights, their responsibilities and opportunities should not depend on whether they are born male or female. That gender should not discriminate because of the gender. They should not be shown the partiality that they are women or they are men, but given equal responsibilities, equal opportunities and equal rights. Gender equality is the equal right of both men and women to have access to opportunities and resources. Men and women have equal access to opportunities and equal access to the different resources that are available. It could be the resources of their education or maybe they're interested in the sports activity and so on. They have a right to participate in the economic sphere and make important decisions. They have right to participate in the economic sphere. Economic sphere means the contribution towards the economy of the country. And not only that, to make important decisions in the family and the society. They should not be shown partiality of the fact that they are also earning members and they should be given right to make the decisions. women with their talent and hard work have proved that their ability is not less than men in any aspect. So women are also hardworking as men, as talented as men. There are so many life examples we can mention. Let it be Sania Mirza or Mary Kom or Sunita Williams, Kalpana Chawla, Saina Nehwal, Pooja Thakur, who was the first officer to lead the Interstate Service Guard of Honor when US President Barack Obama visited India, to name a few of the women achievers. They have got this achievement not just because that they are women, but because of their hard work and determination and their talent. Nowadays, women are successfully working in many fields like the Border Security Force, Indian Air Force, etc. Like Tanushree Parekh, who was the first woman BSF Compact Officer. Bhavana Kant was the first fighter pilot of Indian Air Force. So you can see, women are successfully working in different fields, even fields like Border Security Force, which was considered as a man's job, and Indian Air Force. For the upliftment of women, 50% reservation has been given for women in local bodies. For the upliftment of women, 50% reservation has given to women in the local bodies. To ensure the participation in the local bodies, 50% of the seats are reserved for women. Dear children, an agency called as UNICEF. UNICEF is United Nations International Children's Emergency Fund. It is a program of United Nations to improve the health and the education and welfare of children. UNICEF says gender equality means that women and men, girls and boys enjoy the same rights, resources and opportunities. It says that women and men, girl and boy should have the same right, same resources and same opportunities. They should not be discriminated because of their gender. It does not require that girls and boys or women and men be same or that they be treated exactly alike. They have to be treated alike. They are not to be considered the same, but they have to be treated alike. They are different entities. Men are men, women are women, but they should be treated alike. There should not be any judgmental in the matter of their sex. As of 2017, gender equality is the fifth of 17 Sustainable Development Goals of the United Nations. Sustainable, S-U-S-T-A-I-N-A-B-L-E, sustainable or sustainability, is meeting the needs of the present without the compromising on the ability of future generations to meet their need. It means the present needs are satisfied and future generations' ability are also met. The United Nations, which is a global organization, has given in 2017 17 Sustainable Development Goals. These are for the sustainable future for all, for a better and a sustainable future. And in their 17th goals, gender equality comes as the fifth one. The primary goal being no poverty, second goal being zero hunger, third goal good health and well-being, fourth goal quality education. The fifth one is gender equality. So they consider gender equality as important than any other thing. And by 2030, it aims to completely eradicate the gender inequality. Efforts were made by many social activists from the 19th century onwards. People like Raja Ram Mohan Roy, ईश्वर चंद्र विद्यासागर, दयानाद सरस्वती, महादेव गोविंद रांडे, ताराबाई शिंदे, बेगम रुकिया सखावत हुसैन, ऑल दीज पीपल वर्कड हार्ड टू गेट ईक्वल स्टेटस टू द वुमन. He had put in his effort to abolish the practice of sati and child remarriage. Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar's biggest achievement was opening schools for girls and changing the status of women in the Hindu families of Bengal. Dayanand Saraswati re-established the teachings of Vedas into people's language or language which people could understand. In a time when women did not have any rights and freedom, Mahadev Govind Rande was an Indian scholar and social reformer, founding members of the Indian National Congress Party. He was against the parda system, keeping women behind the veil. Tarabai Shinde was a feminist activist who protested against the patriarchy system of India. Begum Rukia was a Bengali feminist thinker. She is considered as a pioneer of women's liberation in the South Asia. All these people worked very hard to procure the same status men enjoyed in society for women. The freedom women enjoy today, especially in India, are because of all these great personalities who contributed their share. Dear children, today we are winding up our session here. In this class, we discussed only about gender equality, which is an important aspect in our society now. We studied what is gender equality. Gender equality is all the human beings, both men and women, are free to develop their personal abilities and make choices without any limitation. Both men and women should be treated equally. They should not be discriminated because they are man, because they are woman. An agency of United Nations, UNICEF, considers it as the most important thing in the development of our future. It requires that girls and boys or women and men not being the same, but they have to be treated exactly alike. At your homes, children, you being children should help your parents in their work. Help your mother, help your father with whatever possible ways you can. If your mother is working, you try to lighten her burden by doing your things yourself and being responsible at home. I know, children, you are doing a tremendous work at home. I know you help your people, help your parents at home, and you are being very nice and you are growing up towards becoming a good citizen of India. That's all for today's session, my dear children. Be a world full of equal opportunities for both men and women. Thank you. Stay safe. Stay blessed.